Hello viewer, my name is Lisa Wairimo from Local Girls High School, Form 3. Welcome to Science Hub. My colleagues are
Shalil Malesi,
Shireen Taylor.
Today we will be discussing pollution under ecology. First, pollution may be defined as the release of substances or forms of energy into the environment of human beings in such quantities whose effects are harmful to the humans. There are three main categories of pollution, that is, air, water, and soil. A pollutant is a substance which mainly pollutes or contaminates air. Air pollution can be caused by sulfur-based chemicals, e.g. sulfur 4 oxide and hydrogen sulfide. Some of the effects of sulfur-based chemicals are high concentration of sulfur 4 oxide are harmful to organisms in that they lead to bronchitis and heart diseases. Sulfur 4 oxide dissolves in rainwater and forms as acid rain, which tends to lower the soil pH, leading to fall in crop production. Hydrogen sulfide is also poisonous to organisms. It contaminates blood and suffocates victims when inhaled. The second cause of air pollution is oxides of nitrogen, e.g. nitrogen 2 oxide and nitrogen 4 oxide. These are produced from burning of petroleum fuels in industries and emission of exhaust fumes from cars. Effects of oxide of nitrogen. The nitrogen oxide dissolves in rain, forming acid rain. They are also poisonous to animals, affecting respiratory systems when inhaled. Nitrogen 4 oxide is carcinogenic, which means when trapped near the ground due to thermal inversion, these gases seriously diminish visibility on roads. The third cause of air pollution are smokes and fumes. These contain carbon 2 oxide, carbon 4 oxide, and carbon particles. These are produced from industries which burn coal and petroleum fuels. Some of the effects of smoke and fumes are: smokes and fumes affect the visibility due to smoke on roads. When they settle on leaves, they block stomata, hence hinder photosynthesis. Carbon 2 dioxide causes respiratory poisoning since it readily combines with hemoglobin, forming carboxyhemoglobin. Carbon 4 oxide prevents layers of warm air from escaping into the upper atmosphere, causing greenhouse effect that leads to global warming. The fourth cause of air pollution is dust. It is composed of small particles emitted from cement and land producing industries such as cement works. Some of the effects of dust are: dust settles on plant leaves, hence limiting photosynthesis. The fourth cause of air pollution is lead. This is mainly from combustion of leaded petrol by motor vehicles. Lead is added to petrol to serve as an anti-lock compound in vehicle engine so as to improve the efficiency of the engine combustion. The fifth cause of air pollution are aerosols. An aerosol is a substance that consists of very fine particles, either liquid or solid, suspended in a gas. This includes pesticides, insecticides, or fungicides, perfumes, etc. Some of the effects of aerosols are: when copper-based aerosols are inhaled, they cause irritation of respiratory organs of animals. Copper also causes poisoning of water plants and fish. The last cause of air pollution is noise. Noise is the presence of undesirable sound. Some of the effects of noise are: noise affects hearing in animals and human beings. Human beings become insensitive to low-pitched noises. It's an irritant and causes stress in animals. Some of the control measures of air pollution are legislation. You should encourage the use of lead-free fuels in motor vehicles. Develop and encourage use of renewable sources of energy. Examples of renewable sources are the solar energy and the wind energy and also the biogas. Use of biological control methods to control pests, diseases and weeds. This reduces reliance on non-biodegradable chemicals. Smoking in public should be banned. Earmarks should be used in factories, and the government should be a signatory to global treaties on environmental conservation.
We come to water pollution. Water pollution, as indicated in the definition of pollution, is the pollution of water. This involves addition of substances or energy forms into the water bodies in quantities that are harmful to the living organisms dependent on that water. Sources of water pollution. The first source of water pollution we have is domestic influence. Untreated sewage from urban centers gets discharged into rivers used for waste supplies for domestic purposes. This sewage contains diseases causing microorganisms such as bacteria, viruses, and protozoa. The effects of domestic influence as a way of polluting water is that water pollution, it may bring diseases like cholera, typhoid, and amoebic dysentery. The second water pollutant is industrial effluents. Industries discharge various effluents into the rivers, dams, marshes, or freshwater lakes, even in seas. The effluents contains toxic metallic compounds of mercury and cadmium, in addition to acids and other chemicals. The effects of these acids and other chemicals is that they directly kill the aquatic life in the water. Through eutrophication, these compounds also enter the food chain and they accumulate to lethal levels in organisms higher up the trophic level. The third water pollutant is heat. Industries discharge hot water directly into water bodies. This may be from the cooling process or for discharging industrial effluents. Some of the effluents may react among themselves, releasing heat into the water. The effect of heat on water is that heat reduces the amount of dissolved gases in water, e.g. oxygen and carbon dioxide. The fourth water pollutant is oil spillage. Oil is an important pollutant. Oil spillage forms a layer on the water which makes it hard for the animals and the plants in water to breathe. And the effects of oil spillage is that the oil layer on the water reduces oxygen supply to the water, and this may lead to death of aquatic life forms. The fifth water pollutant is agrochemicals. Agricultural chemicals include inorganic fertilizers, herbicides, and pesticides. The inorganic fertilizers contain phosphates and nitrates. Pesticides may contain heavy metals, such as mercury and copper. Other pesticides, such as DDT, contain chlorofluorocarbon, which are not easily broken down biologically. The effect of agrochemicals is that, since most of these chemicals contain the heavy metals, such as copper and mercury, they affect the respiratory activities of aquatic organisms. The sixth, water pollutant is lead. This is a water pollutant mainly from pipes and tanks in domestic water supply systems. Through runoff, it finds its way into water bodies like rivers, lakes, and oceans. The effect of lead, whether inhaled or ingested, are similar as discussed under air pollution. Mercury. Mercury is a pollutant released by industries that manufacture chlorine, sodium hydroxide, ores, and vinyl plastics. The effect of mercury is that the mud in some rivers contain mercury, which is converted to methyl mercury and methane-producing bacteria, which leads to diseases. The effects of mercury is that methyl mercury is violent and very toxic. It is absorbed by aquatic organisms or through leaves and roots plants, hence entering the food webs involving humans, which puts the ecosystem at risk. Then we have the last effect is soil. The last cause of pollution may be soil erosion. Through soil erosion, silt is transported into water bodies. The effect is that this makes water unclean and unfit for human consumption. The silt particularly reduces light penetration, hence hindering photosynthetic activity in water. We have the control of water pollution. We have legislation. The relevant legislation should be enforced to provide for heavy penalties. In addition, international treaties on environment conservation should be adhered to. The second control is that industries should control or treat industrial effluents before discharging them into the water bodies. The third control is that proper treatment and disposal of sewage should be done so as to ensure that our waters don't get polluted. The fourth preventive measures is that to encourage the use of unleaded petrol. Then the fifth control is the public should be educated on correct amounts on inorganic fertilizers used and pesticides to be used. Lastly is that appropriate soil erosion control methods to be put in, such as building gabions, terraces, mulching, and growing of soil cover crops.
Now we go to soil pollution. In soil pollution, some of the sources and effects of soil pollution are the acid rain. The acid rain, some of its effects are that they decrease the soil pH, thus affecting plants and other organisms in the soil. The second one is that it leads to loss of soil fertility, as some plant nutrients are not available for the plant uses as at low pH. The second source of pollution is aerosols. Most of them are sprayed to control pests and diseases in plants and animals, contain heavy metal. An example is copper and mercury. Some of its effects is that these chemicals fall on the soil and plants, taken up where the concentration increases. As animals eat plants, toxicity increases and lead to death of animals. The third source of soil pollution is the petroleum products, such as oil tankers. Some of its effects is that soil organisms fall to obtain oxygen in soils, saturated soils, and therefore lead to death. The second one is that there is coating of plant leaves or respiratory surfaces of animals, also lead to their death. The fourth source of pollution is inorganic fertilizers. These are such as phosphates and nitrates. Some of its effects are like increase in soil acidity, so that soil microorganisms cannot inhabit such soils. The second one is formation of soil organic matter slows down and then stops. The third one is soil becomes exhaust, hence plant and animal life ceases. The fourth one is that soil structure is changed, hence soil erosion. The fifth source of pollution is solid waste. Some of the biodegradable, like some of them are like food residues, old clothing, and papers. Some of the effects are that the domestic and industrial refuse, such as plastic and glass, rubber, and metals, are non-biodegradable. The second one is that it is a nuisance and it is dangerous. It also destroys the authentic value of the environment. The third one is it is a health hazard. Plastic and tins become breeding grounds for the pests and insects and rodents, which are diseases vectors. The fourth one is it limits soil erosion, aeration, and microorganism activities in the soil. Some of the control of soil pollution is that practicing good farming methods, for example, by using biodegradable organic fertilizers. The second one is that treating industrial waste before discharging it into water bodies. The third one is reducing industrial waste discharged by recycling waste. The fourth one is using biological methods to control and kill pests and weeds. The fifth one is recycling solid waste such as paper, rubber, plastic, tins, bottles and glasses. The sixth one is establishing laws on the management of solid waste. And the last one is putting in place international laws and conventions to control radioactive emissions from nuclear waste and dumping.
We have come to the end of our discussion today on Science Hub. I've been Lisa Werimo,
Shalene Malesi,
Shivain Taylor.
Keep it Elimu TV.
Watch and learn.